Good morning, students. How are you all? Good. Okay. So, students, in the last video, we have started our new chapter, that is history lesson number 7, Ashoka, the emperor who gave up war. As we have seen, why do we call him as emperor? Because he have ruled over an empire. Yes. So, in which empire did he rule? So, he ruled over Mauryan Empire, and we have also seen that how did the empire was established, who established it, and what was the story behind it. Okay, so I hope you all have understood. Now, students, was that empire small, big, very big? It was very big. It was almost extended to the whole India. Just a few part was remaining. Correct? Yes. So, now to administrate, that means to run such a big empire, will the task be easy? Will it be easy, students? No, it will not be easy. So, do you ever think that how they might have administrated or ruled over such a huge empire? Okay, so before seeing how they have administrated, do you think that it is easy for any person to rule over India? Almost the empire of the Mauryan Empire was same, and the India is also almost of the same size, right? So, is it easy? No. Now, who is our Prime Minister, students? Our Prime Minister is Mr. Narendra Modi. Okay. So, now, can a person alone run such a big country? No, he cannot. So, for better administration, what do we usually follow? That is the division of a particular place into smaller bits. So, how is the administration of India divided? So, we can say if India is the country, for better administration, it is further divided into states. So, students, how many states do we have? We are having 28 states. So, few students might be having doubt that, ma'am, it is not 28, it is 29. So, let me tell you why it is not 29. Earlier, we used to count Jammu and Kashmir also as a state. But now it is no more a state, that is divided into two union territories. So, now in totality, we are having 28 states and 9 union territories. Okay, students? So, this is how we say now that we are having 28 states and 9 union territories. But still, are the states small? No. There are many big states and there are very small states also. But as whatever might be the size of a state, there are 100,000s of people living in the states. So, seeing what they want to administer or to rule or to give all the facilities, provide all the facilities to the people. Okay. It is not easy. So, what they have done, the states are again furtherly divided into districts. So, number of districts in each state will differ according to its size. Okay. Then, even though districts are used though for even more better administration, the districts are divided into villages and cities. That means we go to the lowest level here. Okay. Understood? Now, this is how the administration of India is made possible through number of divisions, and in that thousands and lakhs of people involved who are providing us all these facilities. So, nothing more or less, it is same how the Mauryan Empire was administrated. So, as we have seen here, India, states, then districts, villages. So, on the other part, if we have to see, then instead of India, we can write here
empire. States is nothing but provinces. Empire is divided into provinces, and here again provinces are divided into districts, and districts are divided into villages. So even at that time, people to provide better facilities to the people and to make sure that administration is running smoothly, they have also divided the empire into smaller bits so that they can rule over it easily and without more hassles or difficulties. Okay, so now we will see at each point how was the administration and what were the people involved in it. Okay, so we will be administration of the Mauryan Empire. So students, here you can see to what extent was the Mauryan Empire extended. Okay, so now if we have to compare with today's India, it is much more larger. So as we have discussed that Mauryan Empire, just like Indian administration, it is divided into many parts for better administration. Here you can see. So empire divided into province, then into states and villages. There is a box given. So you can refer that. So first we are going to look about how was the empire on totality maintained. The king was advised on policy matters by a privy council or Mahamantri Parishad. So these are nothing but the group of people who will be giving their expert advices. That means they will be best in their work and they will advise what to be done and what not to be done. So students, if we have to compare that, even today our Prime Minister, before taking any decision, he would be meeting and taking advices of number of people. As here, the king is having a privy council or Mahamantri Parishad, our Prime Minister will be having cabinet of ministers. Okay, so there are number of ministers who comes under this cabinet of ministers. So our Prime Minister would be taking the opinions, advisors, and then making a decision. So here, once all the advisors are taken and once the decision is made, then this work or the policies would be carried out by Mantri Parishad. So if we have to see, Mahamantri Parishad is of a bit higher level and Mantri Parishad is lower to them. And they also appointed officers to collect taxes and revenues. And these officers also had right to punish the people who did not obey to the rules and regulations of the rulers. Okay students. So not only that, they were, as we have seen, the empire was extended to a great distance. So there was, between one city to the other city, there was a lot of gap and distance. So what they have done, that they have controlled the roads that were connecting the cities so that they can have the good control over the transport and as well as on the trade. So if I am ruling over a place, I would not allow anybody to earn profits from that place. No, if anything is there, that I will only take the profit. I will make sure that all the profits are coming to me. So in this way, this Mauryan administration was also done in such a way that they get most of the profit out of it. So here, northwest part was very famous for their blankets, and South India were very important for those gold and precious stones. As we see that they are very important and they are very expensive. So there were many chances that many people would try to loot them. So it was very important for the rulers to have a good control over the roads. Okay. Next, this was on general about the empire. Next moving is provinces. as we see that India is further divided into many states. So this empire is divided into four provinces. They are Magadha, Ujjain, Takshashila and Suvarnanagiri. If you call it as Suvarnanagiri also, Suvarnanagiri. Okay. So these provinces were very huge. And usually royal princes were sent as governors. And other minor things, whatever they have to take care over there, they used to do and carry out all the responsibilities. So here in this picture, you can see the four provinces of Maurya dynasty or Maurya empire. Here is Magadha close to the Pataliputra. Pataliputra is the capital city of Mauryan empire. Here is Takshashila, Ujjain and Suvarnanagiri. We also call it as Suvarnanagiri. Few people spell it differently. So these are the four provinces of Mauryan empire. Two most important were Takshashila and Ujjain. Why were they so important? As you can see here, Takshashila is located, now it is situated in Pakistan. Okay, so it acted as a gateway to the Northwest and Central Asia. So that they don't lose connect between the other parts. Here they wanted to have connection with the rest of the Asia also. Here you can see, no students, from here northwest and from this side they could have a good control over the Central Asia. Now why did they wanted to have a good relation or to have maintain trade with other places? As we see today also, we have foreign ministers who will be taking care of the matters related to the other countries. We often see that our prime ministers or any important official would be going to different countries and try to maintain a good relation. But why is it so? So that in terms of the time comes when we need any help, we can help each other. So if we don't maintain, if we be rude or if we don't try to talk to them, so would they help when we need? Or will we need if somebody would are there in some problem? No. So it was practiced in the olden times also. They used to maintain good relationship or trade ties between different countries. So next is Ujjain. Ujjain was in the route of south to north. So Ujjain was in the route from north to South India. As you can see here, Ujjain is here. That means almost in the center of the India. So it would connect the northern part and southern part of the India. So it was also a very important place that they could not lose the control over it. They have tried their best to continue to control those places. So next we will see the districts. We have seen about empire, which is divided into provinces, four provinces. Now we'll go to the districts. Now administrative districts were called as Janapadas. They were managed by officials called Sthanikas. And each district was divided into 5 to 10 villages, maybe on the basis of the size of the district. Okay, students. So, here also we can see that our states will be divided into number of districts. And we will be having district collectors and such people who will be taking care at the district level. Okay. And Gopas or Ganardhans maintain the records of all the resources of villages in district. That means as we are having one Sthanika to maintain one district, there was one Gopa or Ganardhan he would maintain all the records of all the resources present in one district. Next, we will be discussing about the villages. So, each village was headed by an official called the Gramin. So, even today in our villages and cities, we will be having a Sarpanch so that he will be taking care of all the things in a particular village. Now, Gramin, what was the role? What was the work that he was supposed to do? He was having two major functions to be played. First was regulate land and water rights. That means now whoever will be paying the taxes, then only they will be getting the right to use over a particular land and the water. So, as we are also paying money for water, we pay water bills, right? Yes. And we also, if we have to buy, if we have to do, we have to take permissions. Yes. Correct, no, students? And the next was to collect taxes and fines. These are the two major roles that to be played by Gramin. And day-to-day affairs were managed by village elders. If some few small problems were arriving between the people, they are fighting for cattle. Array, this fellow's cattle came into my field and he is eating my grains. So, for that, he cannot go to the king or go to the Gramin. There will be many village elders, elder people who have lot of years experiences, and they will be solving the problems. The entire village participated in community activities like village festivals or public entertainments. So, whenever any festival it was celebrated, they used to celebrate or they used to attend that ceremony or activity together. Okay? So, students, again we have a small task for you. So, now you have to find answers for these questions. Who advises to our Prime Minister today on the policy matters? So, I guess we have discussed a few minutes back and I want you to write in detail about it. Who are the people who collect tax? Who are the people who collect tax from the people today? Okay, student, this is a homework that you are supposed to complete today itself. Okay. So, students, you have seen that how was such a great empire administrated so properly. That is only because it was well planned and organized. If it was not organized, then it would be very difficult for them to remain in control in such a place. If they were not organized, then somebody would obviously come and conquer in their lands, and no longer that empire would remain so great, over stretching over great distances. Okay, students? So, students, till now, as we have seen, that many people were involved in the administration of Mauryan Empire. So, these are also few positions or few officials who were responsible for some of the other work. First is Adhyakshas. They are the superintendents, Yuktas, subordinates, Pradeshikas, provincial officers, Rajukas, district officers. So, all these people were assigned with different duties. So, from the starting of collection of tax and revenues, there were multiple kind of jobs that they were expected to do. And as we have already discussed in the last video, we mainly have two sources of information about Mauryan Empire on which we can really rely on. For it was Arthashastra and Indica, right? So, this information mostly we get from the Arthashastra, and it was written by Kautilya.
or we can also say Chanakya. Okay, students. So, according to this source, it is believed that all these officers and along with them, Mahamantri Parishad, they used to meet in the assemblies frequently to take any decision on the policy matters with the king. As we have already studied, right? There was a privy council who used to advise the king on the policy matters. So, they used to conduct a meeting in which they were deciding, they were discussing all the problems and what can be the best solution for a problem. Okay, and they used to meet very frequently to get the solutions for it. And it is also said that if decision was difficult to be taken, they used to go for majority vote. They used to go for the majority vote. Now suppose if we consider there were 25 people, whatever the decision, what if suppose there were two solutions. For one solution, more people have supported, that have got more number of votes would be selected and that would be implemented. So as you have seen, students, it is never easy to administrate a place with a such a great extent to a very great distances. And whether it was in the past or it is today, it was never easy. It is very difficult and it needs a very good organization and planning. And for that, they need a good leader. So students, why was it important to learn about this thing, about the administration? So now if you think in this point of view, that if there was no proper administration, then what would be the end of it? Now as we see that this empire has almost lasted for 100 years or 150 years, whatever it might be, but if there was no proper administration, it would have collapsed within 2 or 3 years only. It wouldn't have existed for so long. So planning and organization can do everything properly. How large it is. Even we are having many number of lessons in our social, right? So if you plan and organize yourself, even that would become very easy. So students, I hope you have understood what all we have discussed about the empire, provinces, districts and villages. Who are the people who will be managing them? Okay, in the next video, we will be discussing about the remaining topics. And still a very important question for us, why did Ashoka give up war? We will be discussing in the next video. Till then, goodbye students. Take care.